Welcome to Yo MTV Raps. And we are in Los Angeles, California. We're in the downtown section. It's real cool and real quiet down here. And we got like an explosive artist with us, you know what I'm saying? From an explosive part of town. So we had to come to neutral ground, more or less. Am I right?
Neutral ground. We got to put the MC8 on neutral ground. Because out here it's a war zone, you know what I'm saying? But we here, we finally here. It's 93 and the place to be. And I'm with 5-5 and we in the house. What up, y'all?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The world famous
MC8's in the house and Compton's Most Wanted's in the house. What's up, all the Yo MTV fans that never got a chance to see MC8 and Compton's Most Wanted? Finally, we here. What's up?
And you might have seen him in Menace to Society.
In Menace to Society, I played a character named A-Wax. Everybody know the G, the shoot 'em up, bang, bang. Yeah, what's up?
Yeah, we're going to get into that kind of deep and find out not just what's going on with my man as an artist, but what's going on with, you know, part of what's happening out here in the hood, growing up in the hood. But let's introduce some. Two brothers hanging out here.
Yeah, right about now, I got my man The Chill from NOTR. Be on the lookout for that fresh new album, you know what I'm saying?
What up,
formerly
man?
A member
Straight
of...
Straight up gangster stuff. What's up, Compton in the house, yo.
Formerly a member of Compton's Most Wanted. Y'all probably remember from the first album, it's a Compton thing, you know what I'm saying? And right here, we got the world famous DJ Slip.
All right.
Just chilling, MTV Raps.
World famous DJ Slip, you know, producer on the CMW tracks along with myself. You know, we just out here chilling on a Sunday night with my man 5-5. Yeah.
So, yo, tell me briefly before we go into this first video, what is the status of Compton Most Wanted as of now?
Well, basically the status of CMW right now, you know, we finally getting the props that we deserve, you know. Basically, we just trying to keep it going with the Compton funk, you know. We the storytellers of the hood, and you know, we just basically trying to keep the flow in the neighborhood.
Yo, we are in it right here in Los Angeles, California, you know what I'm saying? And we're going to get into a lot more of it. But the first thing we're going to do is a slamming video on Yo MTV Raps. Hang out, y'all. MCA.
Yeah.
Now, y'all, on Yo MTV Raps, we are in downtown Los Angeles. Like I said, neutral ground, because where my man is coming from, it's kind of deep out there right about now. So let's like get deep into your background, MCA. Coming from the hood, coming out of Compton.
Well, basically, you know, I started off a couple of years ago, you know, mixed up in the gang, you know, maybe a little drug dealing or something like that, you know, but basically, you know, coming from a brother from Compton in my part of town, you know, growing up in the neighborhoods, you see a lot of stuff that happens and goes on with the police and just with your type of people in particular. So, as for a way for me to get out of the gang situation, you know, I tried to take my position into what I had learned from the homies who had passed and the homies who were in jail and the homies who were just basically still surviving. You know, I took that into a form to where, you know, I could get that to, you know, to homies in every hood, you know, in the United States or throughout wherever, you know, because It's a hood like mine's everywhere. You know, y'all might not claim Crip or y'all might not claim Bloods, you know, but, you know, you still got a gang of brothers who's together and who's still down.
But I'm sorry for cutting you off. What I want to know is, and what a lot of people, I know this is like a lifestyle out here, because I just hearing you speak, it's like this is obviously something that's been going on all of your lifetime, as long as you've been here. Try to explain to people from parts of the country that don't have such a gang situation and don't have the complexity. Why is there that gang situation still going on? Whereas in New York, we had it for a while and then it moved into something else. But here, it still goes on. And why is it so strong?
Well, see, what the difference is between New York, you know, New York had the gangs and, I mean, you know, it wasn't as quite as like L.A. is. Like, we symbolize with the colors and with the rags. And as far as, like, why it's still going on here is because you got over 200,000 to 300,000 brothers and sisters here who live in those ghettos like Compton and Watts and in the projects. And gangbanging is all they know. And when you got brothers and sisters and your moms and your pops is walking around, and you know, you got a 40-year-old pops who's still walking around claiming the hood, you know, what are you gonna be? You gonna follow in pops' footsteps, like I say, and you know, when I speak, you following the footsteps of the homies from the hood, and the hood takes you under is because that is all you know, you know? If you were living in Beverly Hills or Canoga Park, you know, you wouldn't grow up in this Watts or Compton projects, and you wouldn't be, you know. So it's just, I say it's the environment, it all becomes of where you live.
Here we go. Well, that's a perfect way to segue into the title track from the movie Boys in the Hood.
Growing up in the hood, you know what I'm saying, y'all? Peep it out.
That's
yo.
Right. MTV Raps. Whole gang thing out here. Do you ever see it ever maybe, or, you know, turn it into something not as violent, I mean, not as negative? I mean, using that energy to, you know, to manufacture, to produce, you know, to be more positive, you know what I'm saying?
Well, you know, out here, you know, we try to come with, you know, little truces, you know, like we had the truce that happened in Watts, and then you got, you know, people like, they had like the banging on wax tape, like the Bloods and the Crips, you know. That's like some form of unity to let the young brothers know out here that there is something positive that can come out of all the past years that we've been killing each other, you know. So, like, you know, they try to form the truces and, you know, the little picnics and, you know, like I said again, with the banging on wax tape, that's showing a lot of people that there is some sort of unity with these brothers, and it ain't all just about kill or be killed.
I know my brother, a good friend of mine, brother Malik, who organized the Hands Across, one of the organizers of Hands Across Watts, has been telling me that their brother's been holding to the truce in the Watts area, and as opposed to settling beasts with guns, brothers is getting back into, you know, man-to-man, hand-to-hand combat.
Back, yeah, they getting back, you know, to the, you know, the good old days of scrapping.
Yes,
scrapping. What I could deal with, you know what I'm saying? You know, the days of the gun is kind of like, that's why we in the neutral territory, because they ain't out here, you know what I'm saying? It ain't, you know, all it's MCA, it's M-Dub. It's like, it ain't like that, so, you know. To me, it's cool that brothers is going back to, you know, it ain't cool that they still down with it, but you know, I got homies still in it who still with it, and I respect them like they respect me. So it's cool that they going back to the good old days of the, you know what I'm saying, instead of the.
Well, there we go. Now we're going to go into a rap group, a couple of young ladies that go back to the good old days, the old school days of rap. Salt and Pepper with Something New.
Something new.
That's right. We're going to come back with more, my man, MCA. Yo, MTV Raps. Raps, my man, MCA.
In the house.
Compton's Most Wanted.
In the house.
And he's helping explain the situation going on out here on the West Coast, especially what's going on in the hood with the gang situation and, you know, just breaking that reality down out here, helping explain it all. You know, but let's help the audience understand a little bit more about you musically, because there's some deep funk going on your records. What's your musical inspirations and backgrounds for what you're trying to do?
Well, basically, when I deal with MCA, the rapper, I try to come with on the strength of, you know, I like to listen to, when I listen to music, I try to get like gangster inclined, you know.
Now, what do you mean by gangster when you talk about it musically? Because there's, because, you know, this to help the audience know. Now, you know, we got the gangster movies, but on records, you know, what is it that makes it gangster?
Well, basically, I try to create gangster movies on records. Basically, I'm a storyteller about the hood, but then I'm like, I like to just talk about my community and about the brothers in my community and about the sisters, you know, as if I don't try to be like a role model, but I am more or less of an informer, you know, because everybody has the mentality to do what you want to do. So when MCA makes music and I write raps, I come on the tip of, okay, I know that the homies over here like hardcore gangster grooves. So if I like, if I know my homies over here like it, then I know the homies over there like it. The homies in Washington are like it. The homies in New York, Chicago.
Well, wait a minute. Now, what homies did you make a record like Drive-By Miss Daisy for? I mean, that record has such a menacing horror movie type of sound with the somebody pounding on the piano. You got Scarface samples, screaming.
Well, Drive-By Miss Daisy was a record I made back in the days to where when there was a lot of drive-by killings going on. And Drive-By Miss Daisy was a rap, as to say, as if picture this brother who had been in the gangs like deeply, okay? He was true to the gangs, and his homie got shot, and he didn't care who done it, where, what time, he just wanted vengeance. So he goes out, he gets tow up, and he gets drunk and loaded or whatever he had to do to put him into this state to where he just went out and just killed up anybody in his path. And I used Drive-By Miss Daisy to specify that innocent bystander.
You find any kind of pun in the fact that the whole Daisy Duke thing is kind of big now?
Oh, the Daisy Duke. I like watching it. As far as rapping it, you know, that's not my style. I won't knock it, you know, because the brothers making money and they selling records. But, you know, as far as MCA and 8 High Productions and NOTR and Half Mounts, which is me and DJ Slip, we like to keep the gangster funk, you know what I'm saying?
I can dig it. Well, we got some East Coast gangster funk coming at you right now from a brother that's kicking up a lot of noise, kind of heavyweight brother, you know what I'm saying? Fat Joe the Gangster.
Fat Joe, you got to flow, Joe.
Flow Joe, right about now. Well, yo.
What's up, man? What's that Westside CM Dub like, fool? You know what I'm saying? MCA in the house, and if you ain't from my hood, fool, then you get beat down, nigga. Compton, fool. Gia, don't even play, nigga. We ain't taking nothing, you know what I'm saying? Compton, fool, and we ain't playing. Where you from, homie? Where you from? If you ain't down with 8 and you ain't down with yo MTV, fool, then you know what's about to go down. And I mean it straight jacking, fool. Gia, little of that Compton, you know what I'm saying? Little of that menace, AWACS in the half.
A little reminiscent of my man's character in the movie Menace to Society there. Tell us a bit about acting in Menace to Society. What was that like for you?
Oh, man, that was, you know, it was real cool, you know. Basically, being on the strength that it wasn't nothing that was difficult, and I was real comfortable with the character, and it was a movie that related with the hoods and the homies, and you know what I'm saying? So basically, it just caught me, you know, on a regular note, you know. Nothing spectacular I had to do, no outstanding lines, no special effects, no flying, no jumping over riverbeds, no swinging like Tarzan.
How much improvisation was in there? I mean, how much of that was straight off of Tiger Williams' script, or how much room did you have to improvise in your character? Because, I mean, you know, you were so hardcore and spontaneous seemingly.
Well, basically, you know, dealing with Albert and Allen and Tiger, it was, you know, more or less of, it was a young feel on the set, you know. So basically, if it was things that they thought that we knew that they didn't, that came down to real street attitudes, you know, like if they said to me, hey, you know, if you feel that a real G wouldn't do that, or if you feel a real G wouldn't act or say that, then don't do it and put your own in there. So basically, you know, I would ad-lib most of the parts, you know. Most of it was written, and I could relate to it because coming from Tiger and Allen and Albert and them
the directors of the movie.
Coming from them and being from L.A. or whatever and them seeing the situation of how it was here in Compton and Watts, you know, it was cool and the lines were straight up, you know. It wasn't no corniness. So to me, it was basically a good feel about the movie because it wasn't nothing stereotype about it.
Real cool. Menace to Society, definitely one of the stronger pictures to come out in a long time.
Of the year.
You know what I'm saying?
Go dealing, see it.
Dealing with the hood. If you ain't seen it,
go
see it, because it's
yeah.
Major. And now, musically, what you guys got coming up, man? What's coming up with you? I know you got a production deal.
Basically, 8 Hype Productions is in effect. You know what I'm saying? Big Beat Atlantic's in the house. Got my man NOTR over here. My man Chill in the Boom Bam, who ain't here right now. DJ DUI. They'll be starting out at the beginning of 94 with a brand new album. I got another group called Compton for Life, which is a dude named Lil Hawk and Bird. They'll be coming out on also Big Beat Atlantic, you know, breaking with 8 High Productions. And you'll be on the look for the new Compton's Most Wanted album coming out on Epic, you know, in a couple of months. The name of that is called We Come Strapped. You know, it's featuring MCA, a couple of tracks with me and my homies from NOTR, and a couple of tracks from some of the homies in the business that y'all might know. So be on the lookout for the new CMW album.
Much flavor coming, and we want to thank you for hanging out with us.